welcome to Pinoy Crossover. I'm your host for tonight, Ingrid May. And on my right, we have James.
Hey, how are you guys?
And welcome back on the show. We have Franz. Yeah. How's it going?
Good, thank you. Nice to be back.
Great. Well, we have a lot to talk about for tonight's show regarding for Raptors, free agency, and our analysis on games 2, 3, and our predictions for the potential game 4. But first, I just wanted to like talk to you, Franz, like, you know, what you've been up to and everything, and you know, from that viral, you know, photo that we've seen on you on Instagram, like, tell us about, like, you know, give us the what's been up to, what you've been up to.
Yeah, so basically, you know, first game in Toronto, you know, first time the NBA Finals is here. I decided to, you know, go to first, like, you know, go there for a first take, basically. And next thing you know, I see a huge lineup of fans, and it was actually for Good Morning America. So I ended up landing there too, and, you know, next thing you know, Superfan was there. And then they mentioned to us Chris Bosh was going to be a special guest. So basically, you know, we were there for support of the Raptors, and then it just so happens, I guess, you know, that viral video you're telling me, had a, you know, fake Warriors shirt underneath, you know, underneath my my Raptors jacket. People thought it was a Warriors t-shirt. It's not. It's actually to troll Golden State. It says, you know, Drunken State. Yeah. So, you know, when the cameras were rolling, you know, I realized I'm beside Superfan, so I'm pretty sure I'm getting screen time. And this is like, you know, America, right? I'm like, you know what? Let me think about doing this. So I just kind of, you know, unbuttoned my jacket and I showed the Warriors t-shirt, I mean the Golden, sorry, Drunken State Warriors t-shirt. And then, you know, I did the, you know, the quiet, you know, pose where I'm like, you know, just don't tell anybody I'm wearing a Warriors t-shirt underneath. You know, I guess I showed it to my friends, you know, they all laughed and they're like, oh, Franz, you know, you're brave for doing that. You're lucky you didn't get jumped. I'm like, hey, you know, I'm lucky. And actually, I took a picture with Superfan, and it was in front of those guys where I was showing the t-shirt, and they all started booing me. I'm like, you know, relax. It says Drunken State. It's not Golden State. So I'm not in support for the Warriors, but, you know, I'm here for the Raptors.
Yeah, I just found that really funny because I think James and I found that on our Discovery feed, yeah, your photo. So I was just like, isn't he? I swear this guy has been on our show before. So I'm just like, I thought he's a Raptors fan until you look closely at the photo, like, yeah, to zoom in and you actually see it. So that was pretty funny.
Yeah, it's pretty jokes.
And not just that, you've been in like random interviews about, like, were you like lining up, like one of the first one lining up in a
okay, in a so ACC? Yeah, just to clear the air, I know social media and the media is basically saying those fans lined up in Jurassic Park at 6:30 in the morning. It's not true. That's for Good Morning America.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, so you lined up for a Good Morning America.
I was lining up for first take, you know, to see, you know, Stephen A. Smith. But and the funny thing is, I didn't even make it to that show. So, you know, consolation was, you know, Good Morning America. So luckily, first take had a show the next day and also the Monday, you know, following Monday. And I think they're going to have another show this coming Monday, Game 5. So another chance for, you know, any Raptor fans that want to be in the show, just make sure they line up early. To answer your question, that lineup was not for Jurassic Park. Okay. That was for Good Morning America. And then there was just a bunch of Raptors fans. And then we were there. And it just so happens that the guy from Global, he got a glimpse of me. Because me and my friend, we got there. And I saw the guy from, you know, On Point Basketball, you know, shout out to Drew. And I'm like, hey, man, you know, nice seeing you. I haven't seen you in so long. And I just got caught in the footage. So it seems like I'm the first guy in the lineup. But I'm not, you know.
You were like 10th?
Huh?
20th?
I was like way at the back.
Oh, way in the back.
Yeah,
okay.
Way in the back. So it just so happens that I just got there at that time when it was taking the footage. And then when we all got there, you know, we did the show for Good Morning America. A guy won, you know, the tickets, you know, inside, you know, congratulations to him. And then Chris Bosh was there. And at the same time, like, you know what? I just want to make the most of it. So I made sure I was right beside Superfan because I know he's getting screen time.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
So that's what I did. And then there you go. I just, you know, thought of it in the fly. I'm like, you know what? This can, you know, either go off or no one will see it. So I guess, like you guys said, you guys saw it on social media. I'm like, oh.
I guess that's right. What we're going to do next time.
Yeah. And
hold up Pinoy bounce.
Yeah. in Jurassic Park, basically, if you guys, you know, want to get interviewed, you just go basically in front of the huge screen. The cameras are always there. All the newscasters are there. So, you know. That's it.
I feel like we've had such a positive impact for our fan base here in Toronto. Like, I feel like we got a whole country behind the team, yeah, and everything. But I've just noticed that, like, some negative aspects of it. Have you guys heard about what happened with that the guy on CP24?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. What do you guys think of that?
Yeah, you know, in my perspective, it's very, very disrespectful. Mm-hmm. You know, in his behalf, I see I think he's just trying to get, you know, the same, what do you call that?
The same kind of airtime, kind of attention.
Exactly, attention.
But I feel like what you do, it's like that's what most fans should get in order to get that kind of spotlight, not like that, not to be so derogatory and everything.
He did it in a different way, you know, like his was kind of like a negative, you know, mine was just kind of like a trolling, like, you know,
that's fine.
You know, it's not harmful, like, you know, but his, he shouldn't be saying those things, because, you know, it's not good to, you know, say those things about women or about any person whatsoever, you know. So I guess he had it coming. I guess he got arrested.
Yeah. Oh, he did. Yeah, he got that follow-up on that too. So.
Especially in, you know, Canada is known for, like, nice people.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
to, like, just say that those words about Aisha is kind of...
She's Canadian too.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm like, really?
Yeah.
Exactly. You know, we're known to be
polite. But it's Steph Curry,
polite.
You know. A lot of people love and hate Steph Curry's family, so...
Yeah. I don't know why.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.